Hi, Aquarius. Welcome to your quantum entanglement reading with me, Jocelyn, the quantum queen. Let's dive in. Let's see what's coming out for you guys over this next week. This is for Aquarius, sun, moon, or rising. And as always, welcome to my cross watchers. Cross watcher, you could be dealing with an Aquarius, and the message could actually be for you. Ooh. So feel free to take it however it resonates with you and your situation. Keep in mind, these are general and timeless readings, and if you guys would like to book a one-on-one reading with me, you can find my information down below in the description box. And just want to say thank you for liking, subscribing, and thank you for all the good karma donations. All right, Aqua, are you freaking ready? Okay, what popped right out for you guys is, oh, this is so good too. I love this. Look what how good this is. Let me grab one more card. Boom. There we go. Okay, Aquarius. The first card that popped out for you is the Five of Swords. So, as you can see on there, this is like three people. You're deciding to walk away from some type of conflict or some type of situation. Some of you guys could be involved in some type of third party dynamic. Now, what I've been seeing with this card lately, there could have been some type of thing that you were involved in, an entanglement, Aquarius, where it was kind of like, if you guys have been hearing me talk about on the channel lately, the victim, perpetrator, rescuer dynamic, I think you got entangled with both. You're deciding to walk away towards your transformation, and I feel like these are kind of the supporting energies. This is the entanglement going on because you've got the Empress and the King of Wands. So it's kind of clarifying. You guys could have been caught up in something where I feel like this was the rescuer, and then this is someone who was trying to, like, okay, it's more of the shadow side. Like, if you were dealing with someone who was intolerant or had unrealistic expectations and very impulsive and critical. So some of you guys could have either previously or could have someone reaching out just kind of firing off at you. And what I want to say is don't get sucked into it, okay? I know that's easier said than done, but the more that you can just see it for what it is and have that consciousness, that's what's going to help you to transform this, because this is a part of your shadow. So Aquarius, you guys could have been, stay really aware of what this is, because when we're talking about the Empress, it could be about you wanting to birth something, you know, wanting to start a new project in your life, and this is the entanglement. This is the positive side of this energy. So sometimes you can entangle with other people that are in these power positions or kind of like higher up, because vibrationally it's a reflection of where you're meant to be, but it could be where you haven't truly stepped into that power yet. So that's why I feel like there was this really powerful entanglement, because you're being pushed to the next level, Aquarius. So coming out, yeah. So it's interesting. Pisces have this too, starting out pretty soon. We have the Page of Wands. That's what I keep getting, that you could have been dealing with a fire sign. It doesn't have to be, but I feel as though you guys could have been dealing with someone where there was very reactive energy. This is someone also very immature. So maybe this is also you, so stay really aware, because Aquarius, if you could have been dealing with someone who's also part of your shadow, like I said, it could be where you will maybe have an initial impulse to react to this person, maybe coming in at you and trying to assert some type of dominance or control. If you stay really grounded, it's going to help alchemize it, okay? And look at that, Queen of Wands. So huge emphasis on fire. Look at that. Page, Queen, and King of Wands right there, right out the gate. So let me dive into a couple more of these cards, because I'm fascinated. Yep, there it is, the Hierophant. And Nine of Swords. That's what I was saying. I think that you guys have had some type of underlying fear. And maybe it's of a person. Maybe if it's like you have a fear around a person, and once you start kind of entangling and see yourself as being very empowered and kind of like come back into your strength, this is where I feel as though what had kind of happened a little bit is someone was trying to control or like get you to conform, which is not really likely with Aquarius energy. Aquarius are completely non-conformist. So that's why I feel like it's kind of backfiring, because yeah, you might have started out this energy or this interaction with this person maybe in a fearful place, but it's helping to empower you. It's helping you to up level and bring you back into a place of empowerment. And there it is, the Eight of Cups. So there you are, walking away from this connection and just leaving it behind in the past, not really letting it affect you that much. I just feel like you're moving on, and that's what was coming out in the Five of Swords. There's that person that's laying down their weapon and not getting involved in the mental games, because I feel like some of you guys could be dealing with someone who's a bit of, they thrive from drama. And so you're choosing not to interact with it. And that's helping you to really walk away from this connection or this situation. Yeah. So here's in your fear position. I feel like for some of you, a part of the fear is that you are a little bit afraid of the unknown. Like, you don't know necessarily how this person is going to react or what they're going to do. And look at that. The King of Wands. What in the world, Aquarius? Are you dealing with an air sign? Or, I'm sorry, a fire sign? Because that is kind of crazy that those all came out. Page, Queen, and King of Wands twice. But that's you stepping into your power. That's what I was talking about. So here's the shadow side. And here you are stepping into your power and kind of like assuming your throne and realizing who you are. Yeah, because the Magician card, this can be a bit manipulative. Okay, someone's trying to put you in a place of control, possibly. Or for some of you, with that coming out in the mind, some of you guys could be still in a vibration of trauma, and it could be a reflection of what you grew up with, where you still have some trauma of someone that had tried to manipulate you, possibly a parent or an old lover. And so it's still kind of active in your mind where you're looking for it, and it still is kind of manifesting. So that's why I feel like that's coming out really significantly in your mind, is you're still kind of projecting that and holographically creating these situations, because it's from your own shadow, okay? And it's kind of crazy, because what popped out in these cards was also the Strength card. So there you are, getting your courage back. This fear is totally alchemizing into your strength. So it's helping you to get more courage. It's helping you to have more, like, because you're getting prepared, Aquarius. This relationship and this entanglement is actually very beneficial, because it's helping you to have more strength for the next chapter that you're going to be stepping into. So that's why, like I was saying, this could have been a little bit of like an alchemist energy, you know, like I said, it was helping you, because there's something I feel really powerful with the Magician card that you're trying to manifest. And this energy, this person, this whole dynamic, it's helping you to alchemize any type of maybe victim mentality that you had, or a fear that you had about what the next chapter is, maybe the unknown, because you're like, oh my gosh, like, what's going to be on the other side? But this is what is so helpful, because you had this split in your energy and vibration where you were like, you want this thing in the future, but you could also be afraid of it at the same time. So that want and that fear is going to split your energy. And then the fear is going to bring in a holographic manifestation that represents that. And it's not necessarily that it's actually been happening sometimes. That's what's so trippy, is sometimes, like, just because it's so active in you, like I always talk about, those are brain chemical releases. And if those amino acids are going up to your eyeballs, then that's the filter and the energy in which you are seeing the world. So you can see the best and the worst in people. And that's why I feel like I'm picking up on both energies, is that in your mind, you're still thinking that people are out to get you or out to manipulate you and get control over you. And this is totally transforming you, which I love. So Aquarius, I'm going to dive into the extended with this. So if you guys want to join me over there, feel free. Go down below, click on the Vimeo link, and I'll see you over there. But Aquarius, if this is where we leave things, I'm sending you guys so much love, wishing you all the very best, and I'll see you in your next reading. Take care.